by Tartine et Chocolat. So if this is something you're interested in, please stay tuned. And by the way, right now I am at Clark Quay. Let me just flip this camera for you. Ferry boats take you around by the river here and all the way to Marina Bay Sands. So let me take you out on a walk first before I find a nice place to sit and talk about our next fragrance, Tisbon. It's actually very nice right now. It's not sunny here. Right here. So here is my bottle of Tartine au Chocolat's Tisbon. It was released back in 1988 and it's a collaboration with Givenchy. From my research, I believe Tisbon means little one smells good, and I don't know, Tartine au Chocolat means chocolate spread on butter or something like that. And that's the name of the store. It's a children's designer store, and their outfits are really cute. So what is the scent like? This is a very, very fresh scent. It's very refreshing. So the top notes, I believe, are lemon, orange, and galbanum. And then in the middle, you have got white flowers like honeysuckle, lily of the valley, and there's another one which I don't quite remember. Is it freesia or jasmine? I'm not sure. But yeah, I didn't really pay that much attention to the notes on this perfume. This is actually called Eau de Toilette, or classified as an eau de toilette, but I think it acts more as a cologne, so I can spray it quite liberally before and after my runs. So this one, for the base notes, it has like amber, musk, oak moss as well. So I mean, amber I usually associate it with heavier fragrances, but not so in this one. This is amazingly light and fresh, and because it is on an eau de toilette or maybe even just a cologne type of concentration, and I think it has low levels of alcohol in it because it is intended for children, obviously it doesn't stay long and you shouldn't expect it to stay long, but it does its job of refreshing you when the weather is hot, or you know, when you just feel like having something lemony fresh, which doesn't necessarily smell like, you know, cleaning product. I think a lot of people get nostalgic with this scent because they've had it as a kid, or their mother used to spray it on them as a kid, and I can see that. Except, you know, my boy doesn't really like it. He just turned 10, and he's never liked citrusy scent. He doesn't like orange juice, lemon, or anything that has to do with citrusy. So I guess this one is all for me. And it's not too expensive either. I believe this 100 ml bottle cost me about $30. But it's not that easy to find in Singapore. I bought it online and they do go out of stock sometimes. So, but I believe in Europe it's probably easier. I think it's quite popular in Philippines as well because of the similar weather we have here, which is like hot and humid most of the time. So that's my thoughts and impressions for this perfume. I think it's worthwhile to have it in your collection, or maybe just, you know, not even part of your collection, just, you know, if you live in a hot country, just leave it somewhere where it's easy to grab and just refresh you throughout the day. So if you like this review, please press like, share, and subscribe. Thanks so much. So this is my last stop, Clarke Quay. Very, very, very beautiful place. Sadly quiet because of COVID. Hope things turn out well soon, and next time I decide to go around, maybe I'll bring you guys along again. So let me know if you like this kinds of videos, and I will definitely try to do more. Thank you, bye!